herself is fun-loving, loyal, and short. She thinks that women need to be more aggressive, and she claims that she's an expert on engagement.
Seven engaged. You're a professional.
Yes.
Give me a rundown on those.
Well, the first one was my husband, so
we won't count that him. That turned into marriage.
Yeah, kind of. And the first one, the first one after that, we was kind of like on the rebound. Wow. And the second one, my kids are really, really cute and very smart, and his would kind of look like little urchins, so that didn't work out well.
That's actually the third one. Now we're on to four.
Yeah, well, I work backwards.
Oh.
And don't confuse me.
Okay.
And the third one was a very nice guy. He was a DJ, and he had a great personality, but only on stage. For years, people thought I dated a deaf mute. He wouldn't talk to anybody else. Mm-hmm. But he's nice. We're friends to this day. And the fourth one, we just had a terrific time. Everything was going really great, and we had one argument, and the old adage, the going gets tough, the tough get going, he did.
He left.
Yes. And number five died 2 months before the wedding. He passed away.
Why is that? That shouldn't be funny. But
well, some men will go to any length not to get married.
Oh, my Lord.
And so that's number five. I would have married him. And number six, he wanted to live off me and not with me, so I told him to split it. So actually, it's kind of me two and the men three and God one, you know.
Yeah. That's six. Is there another one?
Oh, that was my husband. We didn't count him.
Oh, we didn't count him.
We just counted him.
Yeah. Okay. Let's take a look at the men that Adrienne had to choose from. Now, remember, you're going to pick the man that you think's best for her. Oh, this is strange. First, there was Warren. He's originally from Little Neck, New York, and he enjoys art museums, nonfiction books, and riding his bike. He dates about twice a week, and we ask him if he minds a woman approaching him first. Here's what he said.
After chasing women for so many years and getting doors slammed in my face, I'm ready for someone to walk up to me and say, "Hey, do you know what time it is?" An opening for a conversation. And I'm ready to go, regardless of what it is. I'm for it. Why not? Why should the guy always have to make the move?
All right, next there's Peter. He was born in Austria, and his interests range from basketball to calligraphy. Describes himself as extremely intelligent and well-read. And here's how Peter's last girlfriend reacted to this side of his personality.
She found that one of the charming aspects about me. Because she liked the fact that I was eccentric and that I had an intellectual bent. And she referred to me in a very affectionate way as an egghead. And I've been fond of the term ever since.
Finally, James was raised in Cherry Hill, New Jersey, and he thinks that he resembles Tom Selleck. Says that he's looking for a woman who's smarter than he is, and James told us about a woman he met at a nightclub recently.
She turned every head in that club. And at the end of the evening, I was really feeling good about myself because she chose to be with me. You know? I walk out of that place, you know, real proud, and I go out and I get in my car, and, you know, take a little ride down the road. She invites me over her house, I go over her house, and we start getting close, and all of a sudden, I realize she was a man.
Oh, please. Well, anyway, those are the three men that Adrienne had to choose from. It's time for you to vote. Who do you think would be the best man for her? We're going to take a break. When we come back, we'll meet the man that Adrienne chose. We're going to hear everything that happened on their date. We'll do it in two and two. Be right back. Back, and Adrienne's going to tell us who she selected.
I sucked at Warren.
You selected Warren. All right, we haven't seen each other since today. We always hear both sides. Say hello to Warren Mullison.
Hi, Warren.
Hi.
How are you?
Good.
You can make yourself at home back there, and Adrienne will tell me about the date.
Well, he was different than his video.
Why is that?
Well, I expected him to look more like his video. He kind of didn't. He was taller, and he was kind of scrawny, and on the video I thought that he was wearing a toupee, which I kind of didn't mind, but then in real life that was his real hair, so he actually paid someone to cut his hair like that. It was kind of strange. And his eyes, they didn't blink. He just kind of looked at you, so he looked like a kind of a short version of Lurch from the Addams Family. But other than that, Sammy.
How do you like it so far, Warren?
I'll pass on everything she said.
How did she look to you when you first saw her, Warren?
There were no bells ringing. She didn't sweep me off my feet. I prefer someone a little more curvaceous, a little more voluptuous.
Well, boy, this is not off to a good start. Well, what do you do next?
Well, we were supposed to go out to brunch and then go bicycling. So he came to the door, and he had on those rubber-like Lycra bicycle shorts,
right,
and a T-shirt, which I kind of thought maybe he, you know, first date he should have dressed up a little more. Plus, he didn't bring his bicycle, so I wondered why he had the bicycle shorts on.
Not a bad question, actually. Why is that, Warren?
Well, Chuck, we had planned for bike riding and brunch, so I was prepared to go bike riding. And Adrian was not dressed for a Queen's ball or anything elaborate herself. She was dressed very casual also.
Yes.
Besides, what's most important is the man under the clothes, not the clothes.
What happened after?
Well, we went to brunch, and we had a nice patio table, and, you know, usually you go to these champagne brunches, and I figure that's a meal for the whole day. I don't, you know, eat the whole day, so we kind of separated and got our food, and we came back, and I felt kind of like a little porker, because that plate was just, you know, filled with all the goodies, and he came back, he was eating like a refugee. He had a tomato and an egg, you know.
Tomato and an egg.
Chowing down, and he's just kind of...
Well, you're an aerobics person, though, yeah. So what happened after lunch?
Well, we talked, and we kind of figured that, you know, I'm kind of energetic and outgoing, and he was kind of quiet and a little more boring, so it wasn't hitting off, so...
Well, now, was he introspective, or... Well, maybe it was just boring to you.
Boring. Yeah. My hand was kind of going in the water glasses and just, you know, going like that every couple of minutes.
Well, now, how are you feeling about Adrian over brunch? Any changes, Warren?
Well, I realized this was not a match that was going to be made in heaven or that was made in heaven. It didn't seem like we had enough in common or that we shared enough interests. And
to
get back to the quantity of food, that was done on purpose. I didn't want to eat. I wanted to talk and to ask her questions. It wasn't a brunch to eat. It was a brunch to share conversation.
Uh-huh.
So that was my focus.
I see. Now, after brunch, what did you do?
Well, it was a really nice day, so we decided to go take a boat ride, and I wanted to go home and change, and I changed into this little tube top and short outfit, and I thought I looked real cute. And he didn't say anything, which, if I cared about it, it would have really bugged me, because he wasn't attentive, but...
Well, how did she look in her tube top and shorts?
She didn't look that great. It was not as if she had changed...
What?
It was not as if she had changed into some elegant evening dress.
Well,
she
no, put not on, a tube top and shorts.
She put on shorts and a tube top. I mean, it was no big deal. There was nothing to look at, nothing to talk about.
Well, now, so you went by... Where did you go?
It's the
sailing?
Woman under the clothes. Isn't that what he said? What?
Yeah. Did you go sailing or on a powerboat?
Well, we went on a boat ride, and we talked, you know, for about an hour. Boat ride was an hour, and then he asked where we were going to go for dinner, that he had brought along a change of clothes, and I mentioned that I didn't think I was going to be spending that much time. I had another date. I didn't think I was going to spend all day and then dinner with him, too, so I had another date for that evening.
Oh, you did?
Yeah.
Well, now, did that bother you at all that she made other plans?
I think that's a chance from the beginning. She had me on a strict time schedule.
But Warren, you didn't seem to care. I mean, I can't believe this. You cared about that or just the idea of it?
Well, just the idea that the opportunity wasn't even there for something to develop.
Yeah. Boy, it didn't sound like it developed anyway. How'd the date end?
Well, we drove home, and he walked me to the door, gave a little hug and a peck, and I kind of shoved him out because I had to get ready for my next date, which was fabulous, by the way. I had a great time.
Hey,
oh,
<yeah. laughs> Let's take a look and see who the audience picked for you. Audience thought you did the right thing. Warren, 59%. Oh, they did. Well, sorry things didn't work out for you, too, but we have a nice gift for you, Warren. Maybe we'll see you again under better circumstances. And Adrian, thank you for coming on the show, and good luck
to you.
It just didn't work out. We'll be back with our next guest. Stay with us.
And as a regular at the Comedy Store, I know you will enjoy her act. Please welcome Adrian Rosenfeld. How's everybody? Great show so far, huh? You know what I hate? I hate the fact that there's a double standard about age. Why is it that a man is allowed to get old, a woman like a stale-dated carton of milk, wham, off the shelf? Did I have a sister, who I affectionately called Baby Jane? She's taken to counting her age in dog years. She used to be 11 years younger than I am. Suddenly we're twins. I don't know. She's changed every single documentation with her age on. She's not going to get Social Security until she's 102 years old. I don't know what to do about this. But you know, I did fix her. I got her birthday card once and it said, I know you're shy about your age. 10 years, I think. She didn't talk to me for 4 months. It was great. And we'll do anything, we'll buy anything that says we will stay young. Who here remembers the Apple Lady? Yeah, well, for those of you that don't, it was a small device, looked like a weed whacker and a rotor rooter. It was invented by the descendants of the Marquis de Sade. And was supposed to remove hair from various parts of your body with what was described as a slight sting that you would eventually get used to. If you could get used to this sting, then putting your hand on a running garbage disposal would be no problem for you either. Ladies, our first clue, there was no epigent. Yeah. And now we're going to the cellulite thing. What is cellulite? The experts describe it as fat that is trapped beneath the skin. Isn't that where we want it? My liver's trapped there too. You don't see me working to get that out. And why is it that only women seem to get cellulite? Does that mean that like cellulite is to women like baldness is to men? Yeah. Where's the fairness there? Men get bald, they get distinguished. We get cellulite. It's as cottage cheese thighs, makes us only attractive to dairy farmers. You know, in those magazines like Glamour and Vogue that say, you can stay fit while you're in the office. Yeah, right. So you know, don't pick up the phone like this. No. Reach overhead. Work those obliques. And when you're sitting behind that desk, put that ball between your knees and work those thighs. And when you walk to the file cabinet, don't just walk to the file cabinet. No, walk and squeeze. Walk and squeeze. Walk and squeeze. You do that, you're not going to have that job long. Trust me. By a terrorist than getting remarried. I figure I can beat this one. I can talk the terrorist into marrying me before he shoots me. But you know, it is true, the older you get, the harder it is to find a relationship, because all the guys that are older, they've had so many bad relationships, they can't even say the word girlfriend anymore, let alone have one. I know, I dated all of them. Last guy I dated, he was 56 years old, and he was afraid of making another mistake. I don't know, what do you think, 56? Who cares? Even if he made another mistake, he wouldn't have long to live with it. It's not like he got 50, 40, or 30 years to put up with me, right? He got what? 20, 25 at the most. The first five, they're always happy. The last 10, he's not going to remember. I'll tell him he had a good time. Only five in there, he had to really be concerned about it. I don't know. Where do you go to meet these guys? You don't meet them at the beach. You don't meet him at work. And trust me on this. Standing on the street corner yelling, hey, sailor, I'm lonely, doesn't work because I tried it. It's like after they come an Avon lady, go door to door, ask for the lady of the house, then when they say there is none, I did answer a personal ad once. It sounded so good, you know. It's an entrepreneur, loves moonlight walks, candlelight dinners, looking for a supportive woman for a committed relationship. Oh, flutter, flutter, flutter. Yes, it sounded wonderful. You know what I got? Entrepreneur, the man is out of work. Loves moonlight walks? Of course he does. His car was repossessed. Candlelight dinners? Looks like you forgot to pay the electric bill, too. Looking for a committed woman? Of course, I was supporting you, but he was. Yeah.